Hey guys, it's Margaret. I know I just put up a video a little bit ago about the phone and how I was able to adjust the brightness and exposure before I took the picture, because I can't tell you how many times I've taken pictures and have to edit them after the fact. And I know some of you have already said, oh, you didn't know that? I didn't know. So I'm hoping that there are other people that didn't know that this will help and save so much time. But anyway, I made the little video, I popped it up, and I said in it, like, I couldn't figure out how to lock it to keep the exposure where it's at, but I figured it out. So I know I look a mess, you guys, but I just wanted to pop on and show you instead of just making a whole big other thing about it. And yeah, because if I can help, you know, that's my whole thing, is like, I just figured this out. So certainly there's somebody else who hasn't figured this out yet. I know I'm geeking out about it, but I really am. I'm geeking out about it. Okay, so I'm going to switch over to my phone so you can see my phone. So right now, here we go. That's what my phone is seeing. It's sitting down. So here we go. I'm watching it to see if it's going to show up right. Okay, so I'm taking pictures. It might be kind of choppy, just because it's like trying to figure out, what are we doing here? So this is my phone screen. I'm going to switch over to square mode because that's what I do. Now before I was showing, like, if I take my thumb and I tap it, it'll focus, right? But then that little sun pops up. So when that sun pops up and you tap it and you can slide it up or down before you take the picture to adjust the exposure, right? So that's what I was showing you in the last video. But I couldn't figure out, because after you take, here, I'm going to make it dark so you can really tell. After you take the picture, it pops back to what it normally sees. Watch. See, look, it pops back. But let's say I liked it where it was. No, I want it back on square. I liked it, you know, like there. I want it super duper. Let's make it super bright just so you can see the difference. But let's say I love it like this, but I want it to stay for every single picture just like that. So I am going to take my thumb and I'm holding down on the screen. So you see that AEAF, that lock? So that's auto exposure, I think, auto focus lock. So now when I change my, I'm using my thumb and I'm pushing up the little sun. Now when I take the picture, it's not going to pop back to normal. It's going to stay just like that. And so I can take all the pictures I want at that exposure. Now this isn't actually how I'm going to take my product shots, but I just wanted to have it look different so you could see that it's staying put. And then when I want to get out of that, I just tap the screen again and boom, it goes back to normal. So again, you, like, after you focused it, because if you try to focus after and you tap the screen, it'll go away. Then I'm holding down with my thumb on the screen and then that pops up, the AEAF, and then I can adjust up and down for my pictures. And then boom, take that picture. And it'll stay right there unless I adjusted it just then. Okay? So, okay, I'm going to flip back over so you can see me, even though I'm a mess right now. Okay, stop screen sharing. So, yeah, I just wanted to share that with you guys. I know I'm totally geeking out about this, but I think, oh, my gosh, it's such a time saver. I hope you guys haven't been wasting as much time as I have having to edit pictures after the fact. Pardon me. So yeah, okay. Hi, I see some friends in the chat. Hi, Debbie, Wendy, Tracy, Chris, and Jolene. I just wanted to come on and show you guys that. And yeah, you may already know. And like I said in the last one, you can make fun of me because I didn't know this after all these years. But better late than never, right? Okay, thanks so much, guys. Go over there and hit that thumbs up. And I'll talk to you later. Bye.